Hello, good evening everyone. In the last class we had seen the factors on which resistance of a conductor depends, and before that we saw what is the meaning of resistance. Resistance is the opposition offered by a conductor to the flow of current, and we have also seen resistance is of a conductor is directly proportional to the length of the conductor, and resistance is inversely proportional to its area of cross section. Okay, so and also it depends on the material of the conductor. It is different for different materials, and it is directly proportional to the temperature. As the temperature increases, the resistance also increases. So if you combine these both equations with these both expressions, you get R proportional L by A. So R becomes equal to, when you change this proportionality sign by an equal to sign, you have to place one constant, and that constant is rho. Okay, and where rho is resistivity or resistance, specific resistance. Okay, it is constant for a given material. Okay, and at a particular temperature. Okay, and if L is equal to 1 meter and area of cross section is 1 meter square, then R becomes equal to rho into 1 upon 1. So R is equal to rho, or rho is equal to R. What is rho? Rho is resistivity. Okay, so we'll define what is the meaning of resistivity. Okay, now resistivity is the resistance of a conductor of length 1 meter whose area of cross section is 1 meter square. Okay, and the unit of SI unit of resistivity is ohm meter. Okay, so SI unit of resistivity is ohm meter. Then we'll see the resistance of a system of resistors. Now first way the resistors can be connected is series connection. Okay, so the first way in which the resistors can be connected is series connection. Okay, so series connection. Resistors are said to be connected in series when they are connected end to end. That is, this end of the resistor R1 is connected to the first end of the resistor R2, and the second end of R2 is connected to the first end of R3. That is, they are in a single line. Even R1 and R2 here also, they are connected in series only. Okay, even R1 and R2 here are connected in series. Now let us derive an expression for resistance of a conductor, resistance of resistors which are connected in series. So let us calculate the, or derive the expression for resistance of a system of resistors connected in series. Now let us consider three resistors R1, R2 and R3 connected in series in the circuit. Okay, and which are connected to a battery whose potential difference is V. Now when resistors are connected in series, you all know current flows through the conductors. So there is no alternate path for the current to get divided. So current through all the three resistors, there is one single path. So current through the resistors remain the same. Now what remains becomes different is the potential difference. Why? Because the potential difference we measure across the conductors. So the potential difference across R1 will be, we have to measure it across AB. So let us take this as say V1, and the potential difference across R2 we have to measure between or across BC. So let us take this potential difference as V2, and the potential difference across the resistor R3 we have to measure across this, between these points C and D, and let it be V3. Okay, so this V should be equal to V1 plus V2 plus V3. The same potential difference is divided between the three resistors R1, R2 and R3. Okay, so when resistors are connected in series, the current through all of them remains the same. The current remains the same, but what gets divided is the potential difference. So V becomes equal to V1 plus V2 plus V3. And from Ohm's law we know V is equal to IR. So let us take, let R be the equivalent resistance. Okay, let R be the equivalent resistance of, let us take it R suffix S, be the equivalent resistance of R1, R2 and R3 in series. Okay, so it becomes like V is equal to I into RS. This will be I into R1 because it is a resistance, potential difference across R1. V2 will be I into R2. V3 will be I into R3. So I into RS, you can take I common here, R1 plus R2 plus R3. You can cancel I and I on both sides, so you get RS is equal to R1 plus R2 plus R3. So the equivalent resistance of a system of resistors connected in series is the sum of the resistors or sum of the resistances of those resistors. Okay, so this is how we find the equivalent resistance of a system of resistors which are connected in series. Now let us find out the resistance of a system of resistors connected in parallel. Okay, so let us find out the resistance of a system of resistors in parallel. Let us consider three resistors R1, R2 and R3 connected in parallel. And when are the resistors said to be connected in parallel? When they are connected between common points. You can see R1 is connected between AB, R2 is connected between AB, R3 is connected between AB, and what about this battery? Battery is also connected between AB only. You can see the positive terminal of the battery is connected to A, the negative terminal of the battery is connected to B. There is no other device here other than the key. Of course, the key will be there, the plug key or the switch will be there. Okay, so here when the resistors are connected in parallel, okay, the potential difference across each remains the same, because potential difference we always measure between two points, and between the same two points the all the three resistors are connected. Whereas there is alternate path for the current to get divided. There are three paths here. So the current I, the total current I gets divided into I1, I2 and I3. So I becomes equal to I1 plus I2 plus I3. Okay, so we know V is equal to IR. So I is equal to V upon, let us take it as RP. RP is the equivalent resistance of a system of resistors connected in parallel. So I1 will be equal to V upon R1. I2 will be equal to V upon R2. I3 will be equal to V upon R3. Why the potential difference across all the resistors remains same? Because all the three are connected at between the same two points, and potential difference we measure, okay, across the resistors. So it is going to remain the same. Why is the current different? Because there are three different paths for the current to get divided. So I becomes equal to I1 plus I2 plus I3. So you can take V common here. If you take V common, you get 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3. Okay, so you can cancel V and V. So what you get? 1 upon Rp is equal to 1 upon R1 plus 1 upon R2 plus 1 upon R3. Rp is the equivalent resistance of a system of resistors connected in parallel. So, when resistors are connected in parallel, the reciprocal of the equivalent resistance is equal to the sum of the reciprocals of the individual resistances. Okay, so this is about the equivalent resistance of a system of resistors which are connected in parallel. Okay. Now let us consider the circuit given here. We have 4 ohms, 4 ohms, 2 ohms and 2 ohms. Now see which points are connected to the battery. See here, A and B are connected to the battery. These are the common points. So here this 4 ohms and 4 ohms are in the same line, connected end to end. So this 4 ohms and 4 ohms are in series. And even these 2 ohms and 2 ohms are in series. Okay. So for the upper part, equivalent resistance of upper part, equivalent resistance of say 4 ohms and 4 ohms, since they are in series, so it will be R1, let us take it as R1, it will be 4 plus 4, which is 8 ohms. And equivalent resistance of 2 ohms and 2 ohms is, let us take it as R2, is equal to 2 plus 2 because they are also in series. So it becomes equal to 4 ohms. Now this upper part and the lower part, you can see both are connected between the same common points AB. So this part, upper part and this lower part, they are in parallel because they are connected between the same common points A and B. So, you know, 1 upon R should be equal to 1 upon R1, that is equivalent resistance of the upper part, plus 1 upon R2, that is resistance of the lower part. So total resistance here of the circuit is 1 upon R1 plus 1 upon R2. So which is 1 upon 8 plus 1 upon 4. LCM of 8 and 4 is 8. This is 8 1s are 8. So multiply this by 1. 4 2s are 8. So multiply this by 2. So 1 plus 2 is 3 by 8. So 1 upon R is 3 by 8. So R will be equal to 8 by 3 ohms. This is the total resistance or equivalent resistance of the circuit. Now, let us find the current. Okay, current we know is given by, current in the circuit, I is given by what? V by R. The potential difference connected here is 10. And resistance R is 8 by 3. Denominator of denominator goes up. So 10 3 is a 30 upon 8 amperes, or say 15 by 4 amperes. This will be the current drawn by this circuit, or this will be the current flowing in the circuit. Okay, let us consider the same this thing when the connection changes, that we'll see. So in this case you can see the common points between which from where the battery is connected is A and B. So here 4 and 2, this are connected in series, this 4 and 2 are in series. Okay, so resistance of this part will be 4 plus 2, that is 6. So I will take that as R1. R1 is equal to 4 plus 2, that is 6 ohms. And R2, this will be 4 plus 2, that is 6 ohms. And you can see this 6 ohms and this 6 ohms are connected between the same common points A and B. So total resistance R will be, 1 upon R will be 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2. That is 1 by 6 plus 1 by 6, which will be 2 by 6. which is 1 by 3. So R will be equal to 3 ohms. And current is, total current drawn is, I is V by R. V is 10, R is 3. So you get this 3.33 amperes. Okay. Now let us consider the same thing once again. That is one more possibility. Now let us consider it this way. Now the battery is connected between these two points. So you can see these all are in series. So this R1 will be 2 plus 4 plus 4. Okay. So R1 will be equal to what? 2 plus 4 plus 4. That is 10 ohms. And this R2 is just 2 ohms. That is a single resistor. And this combination of 10 ohms and this 2 ohms are in parallel. So 1 upon R, that is the total resistance of the circuit, will be 1 upon R1 plus 1 by R2, which will be equal to 1 by 10 plus 1 by 2, which will be equal to, LCM will be 10, 1 plus 2, 5 is a 10, so multiply by 5. 1 plus 5 is 6 by 10, which is will be equal to 3 by 5. So resistance will be equal to what? 5 by 3 ohms. This is a total equivalent resistance of this, of these, all these four resistors which are connected. Okay. So this is about the series and parallel combination of the resistors which are connected either in series or parallel. Let us see few more sums in the next video. Okay. Till then you can just go through this video. This is just a revision of what we have already done earlier. Okay. I hope you can see everything is clear. I can see it clearly. Even you all should be able to see it clearly. Happy Independence Day.